So today's update of the aquarium gallery is a pretty exciting one. You see, today in the aquarium gallery, I'm going to be revealing to you guys for the first time what the 2,000 gallon concrete aquarium is going to look like. You see, all of the forms are off, and I think you guys are going to be pretty excited to get a real visualization of what this is going to be, ending up looking like. But there's somebody else that's even, a few people that are even more excited than you and I. The Rays cannot wait to get into their new home. These guys are getting pretty big. Looking really good though. Doing well in their 100 gallon grow out. They'll be fine in there until the cement tank is done or concrete tank is done. And the big guy is also really excited to get out there. Can't wait to see how big he's gonna grow in that tank. Something you're gonna notice here though is my ceilings are still kind of ripped apart. This is just a cloth here placed on top of the tank in case any cement or the PVC cement dripped on top of it or any of the insulation, anything like that. But there's been some challenges and some frustrations. You see, last Thursday when I uploaded that video, I actually had no power in the house. And power actually didn't come back on till about 12 hours later. All the tanks ran on generators, everybody's fine. My number one priority is running the tanks on generators as well as the internet, everything else, you know, not that important, but only a fish keeper would say that. On the topic of generator though, wait till you see the electrical outside. It's looking really good and we've made a lot of progress. Before we go out there though, let's take a look at what's changed inside here. 200 amp panel has been installed. It's still quite a mess in terms of needing to be cleaned up, but it is installed. I'm gonna have to build new doors to fit this area because this panel was actually twice as big as the 100 amp. However, everything electrical will be completed today. Let's go outside now. Before we jump inside though, let's just take a look at some of the things that I've had to do outside and have done. One of the things that was the worst part of this electrical was digging this little trench. Just this tiny little trench that runs maybe 10 feet total. It's about 18 inches deep. It doesn't look that deep now because it was raining most of this time and a lot of the dirt was kind of slumping back in there. But all of that electrical is done. I hope to be able to fill this back in within the next, you know, week. Hopefully today or tomorrow, really. And then that runs up into the building here. We'll take a look at the panel. This thing here is what I was getting excited about just a moment ago. Let's take a look at the panel. So the panel is installed, and a lot of people said, you know, you should, you know, make sure you can switch this off to a generator and run the whole building. And I've been talking about, you know, updates in all of my videos about what I'm doing and what I'm not. But I've already mentioned a few times that I'm going to be able to, actually one of the first updates of this building, I showed this panel and how it works. I'll be able to, when the power kicks off out here during a storm or whatever, all I got to do is switch this over to generator power, pick what I want to run off the generator, and then plug my generator into here. Then this entire building is run off generator power. Still so much to do outside. A lot of cleanup, a lot of, you know, I got to take care of that gravel out there. There's a lot to do, but it's little jobs that I can get done over time. And as long as I keep doing something every day, we'll get this done eventually. On the topic of getting things done, we're going to talk about timelines here in a second and when I expect everything to be completed. But for now, I bet you can't stop looking behind me. Now, we're getting excited. The forms are all off of the tank, except for the window forms. I've left them on, probably take them off in a week or so. Just want to make sure that these runs here are fully cured and can withstand the sag that they might have to go through. But this is solid, 8 inches by 8 inches, 4 5/8 rebar running through it. This thing is built like a tank. You're probably wondering, what are the dimensions of these windows? This one here, I believe it's 52 inches long, maybe 54 inches long, 28 inches tall once the forms are removed. This one over here, 88 inches long, 28 inches tall. Now last week, all you've seen was the forms were up, the cement was poured, and we still had to do the flooring. The flooring is different. You see, when it came to the flooring, the first thing that had to be done was a metal mesh laid down, and this is going to give something for the pipe to hold on to and add a little bit of, you know, well, actually a lot of structural integrity to the cement floor. After the mesh was laid and pipe zigzagged all the way along it, with an entrance and exit at the end there, which I'll talk about what that's for in a second. About 3 inches of cement were poured on top of it, then smoothed out. Pretty basic and simple. And that was done just on Thursday afternoon, and it's now Sunday afternoon, so you can see how fast this stuff really cures. Those pipes go underneath the cement here and exit over here. You guys will remember I talked about these ABS pipes. That is the entrance or the input to the filter, and these are the outputs. We'll talk about filtration here in a second, but let's first address these pipes. Those pipes are eventually going to feed into, through this wall, and into the utility room, which is an absolute disaster. I don't have any power out here, so you're not gonna be able to see specifically what's gonna happen out here. But I'm going to be installing about a 60-gallon hot water heater instead of the tankless water heater. The hot water heater, I can tap into that, and it'll be much more energy efficient than the tankless. I just need too much water out here. I kind of went through the numbers. It makes more sense to do the common hot water heater. And if I do that though, I can tap into that hot water heater, put the tank on a pump with a thermostat tapped into those lines. And when the tank temperature drops, that pump kicks in and pumps hot water through those lines underneath the tank, which heats the tank. When it reaches temperature, shuts the pump off. Just like in-floor heating, it's very efficient and it should work really nicely. Plus, this will act like a massive heat sink, helping to heat the entire room and keep it warm. Now on to filtration. Clearly we have the pipes installed in these three bottom ones. They're going to lead into the other room here, into a pressurized canister filter that will be here about the size, same size as that garbage can actually. All of this will clearly be cleaned out. And that canister filter will feed back to the pipes up top, but there's three pipes there. I'm going to be using them for different things, but two of those pipes will be used for the canister filter. The other two will be used for the overhead sump filter. That's what I want to do for additional filtration. You see, the canister will serve to be mechanical as well as biological and will be sized appropriately to the size of this aquarium, but I'm keeping a really massive fish in here that produce a massive amount of waste, and especially ammonia. So I need a lot more biological filtration than a canister would be sized for. With that said, the overhead sump will also allow for not only more biological filtration, but fine particle filtration that's easy to maintain and take care of. But let's talk about a timeline for this aquarium. When is it really going to be done? And that's like a really interesting question because I don't have any patience, but the thing I can't do is make concrete cure any faster than it has to. We've got about 25 days left of curing. Then I'm going to acid etch and remove all the built up calcium that's been pushed through the concrete, and followed by epoxying the entire inside of the aquarium. And I estimate to have the final cure and epoxy being done within the next 40 to 45 days. At that point, we can install the viewing panels. Now to install those, I'll be doing just like my plywood aquariums, taking those 1.5-inch acrylic panels, which I've got to order on Monday, and silicone them in place. Pretty straightforward that way. I'll also have to brace them temporarily as it cures. And I might even take some masonry bolts and bolt it through the acrylic into this concrete tank just for extra assurance. We'll have to see how the silicone holds up and what it's looking like after we've done the install. But with that said, you might be wondering, acrylic and silicone don't mix, for those that know that. And that's true. When it comes to building an acrylic aquarium, you have to use acrylic cement, which fuses the acrylic on a molecular level. However, when it comes to silicone, silicone's great for glass aquariums, but it doesn't adhere very well to acrylic. So if you built an aquarium out of acrylic, it would just, with silicone, it would just blow apart. But that doesn't mean it can't hold on to it. For example, you can use it under low pressure zones, or when it's only acting as a seal. And that's exactly what this is going to be doing. All of that pressure is pushing against it. It's not pulling out, pushing against it. So that silicone will not only hold the panels in place, but it will also act as a seal. Basically, I hope to have this tank completed in the next 50 to 60 days. And that means filtration and everything filled with water and cycling ready for fish. However, I do have a little bit of travel over the next couple of months as well, so those dates might get in the way. With that said, I'm going to move as quickly as possible as I can with this. Now the 375, obviously I can't rush the 2,000 gallon, but the 375, we already have that tank inside, the stand is built, why can't I just throw the tank on top of that? We'll go back inside for this. You see, this is the 375 that's going outside on that stand. And the problem with that is, wait till he comes, he's coming. He's in it right now. And what the plan was originally was to complete the cement tank or concrete aquarium and move him into it, freeing up the 375, moving the rays in there, freeing up that 100 gallon. And then, you know, the 375 could be turned into a planted aquarium. But I'm about 60 days away from being able to do that, and I'd like to get some things done a lot sooner. So one of my options is to take the ultimate blood red Asian arowana out of this tank, put him in this tank with the rays, he'll do just fine in there. Move the Asian arowana, the big guy, from his tank into the 375, take the 375 and put it outside and move forward with that. The problem with that though is putting him under a lot of stress, moving him twice as much as I need to. Instead of just moving him from here to the cement tank, I'll be moving him from here to there, from there to the cement tank outside. And you know, every time I do that, he gets a little bit stressed out and, you know, doesn't want to eat for a month or two. And if I move him twice, he's not going to be eating for 2 or 3 months, maybe more, which could prove to be extremely detrimental to his health. So I really need to either figure out how to move him with minimal amount of stress or just be patient and wait. What do you guys think? Ultimately though, the health of the fish is my number one priority and always will be and always has been. So we'll have to figure something out there to keep moving forward. Ultimately, you know, there's not a lot holding me back here besides timelines and the time it's going to take for this to cure, the time I, you know, when that cures, then I can move this out here, and the racking system, which we're going to talk about here in a second. It does seem as though everything is going to happen almost all at once, and you know, at about the 50 to 60 day mark, it's going to be very busy out here. In the meantime, there's still a tremendous amount to do out here, so every week we'll be moving forward. But let's talk about the racking system now. So to remind you, the racking system here is going to be about 22 feet long. It's gonna hold 10 120 gallon aquariums. Each one of those 120 gallon aquariums is gonna showcase a different aspect of the hobby. I'm gonna get more specific on that in a second. But you guys will see the racking system, the aquariums, as well as the filtration system, the plumbing, everything, almost all at once in about 30 days, less than 30 days, most likely, I think it's like 3.5 weeks now. Once you see them, about 30 days from then, they'll all be set up and ready to run. So again, this is just a timeline of things we need to be patient and wait for, but it's all coming together and it's all going to happen. And just as a reminder, it was just 2 months ago that this used to be my old garage. Tore that down, laid a new foundation, built an entirely new building, got the cement tank in here. You know, everything's coming along and we're moving tremendously fast. It just doesn't seem that way because all we want is the aquarium set up and running. So let's talk about what we're going to be stocking all of these tanks with. First and foremost, the 2,000 gallon monster tank is getting monster fish. The rays that you've seen inside might only be this big, but within the next 5 to 6 years, they're going to be this big. You know, those guys, you know, grow to 24, 30 inches and that pearl, you know, substantially larger. So it'll be getting those 4 stingrays. I might potentially add a couple of more, making it 6. The Asian arowana, the big one, is going in here immediately. And then eventually that small ultimate blood red Asian arowana will be going in here as well. I just need to grow him out a lot more, maybe get him to at least 12 inches before I feel comfortable putting him in here. In the meantime though, other large fish will be going in here as well. Potentially we'll do some bichirs or bikers or bashirs, however you want to pronounce that. I don't know, I want to do some larger, bigger fish. Maybe we'll get into some big silver dollars again now that we have a sizable tank. Maybe a true giant gourami. I've always liked those guys. But ultimately there's a huge ton of options with such a big tank and I'd really like to make it a true monster fish tank. And some people have asked if I will be aquascaping it. And the short answer is, sort of. You see, once it's epoxied and set up, the only thing that I might do is add some large, very large pieces of driftwood or rocks and some plants that don't need a substrate like Java fern, Java moss. Probably won't do Java moss. Maybe we'll do some floating plants like water lettuce. I don't know. And followed by Java fern, Anubias, right? So those plants look pretty great and they will grow on large pieces of wood as well. Will I be doing a substrate? Probably not. It's just too big of a tank. 70 square feet to vacuum and take care of. Eventually, this is going to, it's going to cause a big problem in this tank in the long run. I don't know though, maybe I could do a light substrate or whatever. Will it be aquascape though? The short answer is lightly aquascape, but the main focus will be on the fish and showcasing those guys. As for the 375, so many questions on what I'm putting in there. And another short answer is I'm not 100% positive on the stocking, but I do have an idea on what I want to do for the scaping. You see, when I originally built this 375 gallon tank, I put the filtration on this end specifically because I knew one day it would become almost like a room divider and you could see all the way through it. You don't want any pipes or anything showing, so you throw them all the way to the end. And because it's a see-through tank, one of the things I'd like to do is have the aquascape take up maybe half the tank, three quarters, maybe not, we'll have to see, with long branches and plants and so forth, a nice substrate. I don't think it'll be high tech. It'll most likely be a low tech aquarium simply because I won't be filling the entire aquarium with plants. And then I want to do a lot of smaller fish. I'm not doing big fish in this tank. I'll have a big school of, you know, relatively larger fish, but then a tremendous amount of smaller fish as well, including some substrate type fish like corydoras and whatnot. It's going to be more so of a community tank that's extremely achievable for the common hobbyists, yet done on a much larger scale. And I'm really excited about that. I guess I'm kind of lying because I do know what I do kind of want to do for stocking of this tank. But when the time comes, I don't know if they're going to be available because some fish are seasonal. So I don't want to say one thing and do another. So we'll just have to wait until this tank is ready to be stocked and we'll move forward. And you're probably wondering, what about the other tanks? What are we going to do with all those? Well, for the racking system, as I mentioned before, there's going to be 10 120 gallon aquariums. Each tank is going to showcase a different aspect of the aquarium hobby, more specifically a different locale in the hobby that we enjoy keeping fish from, for example, Africa. But Africa has a few big lakes that are really popular, including Malawi and Tanganyika, and Madagascar is also really popular, so tanks will be dedicated to each one of those lakes and areas. Then I want to do South America, I want to do Central America, I want to do Australia, I want to do Asia, I want to do saltwater tanks. Now when it comes to saltwater, I won't be focusing on locales with that. Like for example, only coral from Australia. I won't be doing a biotope like that for the saltwater. There will mostly likely just be your basic, you know, I'm probably going to have two of them here at least. And one of the things I want to do is have a fish only tank or a fish only with live rock, which I could showcase the fish more so. And then the other tank showcases coral more so. So it's kind of giving you a reef idea and then a fish only idea. And the fish only would kind of be like the little tank that I have inside. As for what's going in what, I don't know yet. We haven't gotten to that point yet. But like I said a minute ago, some of these fish are seasonal. So by the time this racking system is set up, I don't know if these fish will be available or not. So I gotta wait until everything's ready to run, then we make decisions on stocking, but I will be including you guys on that heavily. We're looking at a time frame when all of this is kind of coming together all at once, which is exciting, but also a bit nerve-wracking to have it all happen at once. And clearly I'm not going to be able to stock and scape all 10 of these tanks all at once. So one of the things I was thinking about was starting at the end, focusing on two tanks at once, and then everything on this side will quarantine and temporarily hold all of the fish that are going in these tanks, and we slowly move our way over. I think that's the best plan of attack for that. Now, there's been a ton of questions about specifics about a lot of the work out here, and you know, some people want complete tutorial videos on the tank or this or that, and I gotta say that these are just updates for the time being. I truly enjoy bringing you guys along every step of the way. But for example, a complete tutorial from start to finish on this tank will be done. I've been documenting and filming it the entire time. So you will get those step-by-step videos in the near future. Hopefully we'll be able to get them out within the next 2 or 3 months. Again, tons of work to be done out here, but you're probably wondering what's next. Now that, you know, it's a waiting game with this tank, what can I continue to do and what's my plan of attack this week? Very simple. There's tons of holes in the walls from the electrical. I'm going to patch up all those. I'm going to repaint the floor, make everything look pretty out here again. Might take a couple of days to do that. I'm also going to start ordering all of the equipment that I need. for the big tank, as well as waiting for a lot of other equipment to arrive. Again, just a waiting game. This week, I'd also like to focus on the outside of this aquarium. You see, it's kind of ugly right now. It's just cement. So I've got a couple of options here, and I need your guys' feedback and opinions on what to do with the outside. One thing that I'm going to do most likely is for sure on the outside is paint it or stain it just to seal the cement. And if that looks really good, I might leave it as is, or I might face it with some fake rock and make this look like a more natural aquarium. And I don't know, let me know what you guys think I should go with. Let's probably start out with staining and painting it, see what that looks like, because we've got to do that either way, and then go from there. And I'll also, at the same time, I'll look around for some options on rock panels. One of the things that I'm really excited about this, though, is because this is such an open top up here, is that I'm going to try to surround the tank with, like, live plants that are hanging from the wall, drooping over, you know, sitting on top in the back. And the room is being lit enough for those plants to grow, like low light plants, but we also have, I can also add some fake lighting in here to supplement the growth, potentially build some sort of, and this will happen much further down the road, but potentially build some sort of, you know, 3D rock waterfalls or something. I don't know what I would do there, but I do have an idea of some of the things that I'm thinking about, and I'm just tossing ideas around here, is that the rocks come up all the way to the ceiling and they match the sides here and the whole tank, so it looks like this is all one thing, but the rocks go up there along the front, along the side for the most part, so I can actually get in behind it and walk underneath of it and get behind it or do whatever I need to do. But maybe have a waterfall coming down there, some plants that are, you know, growing off of it, maybe mosses. And that's really exciting to think about, but that's something that's going to have to happen after the entire gallery is set up. You see, over the next year or two, there are so many different things that I want to add, upgrade, change. And what you guys are seeing now is just the, you know, the base work. There's going to be so many exciting projects and things that we're going to be working on while we're out here. But I mean, the number one thing that I'm most excited about is just the educational aspect of the fish keeping hobby and, you know, showing you guys what I've done so you could potentially emulate it, whether you want to do, you know, get inspired by the scaping, or I introduce you to a fish or educate you on a fish you've never seen, or you see some of the products and the equipment that's running out here, you know, you get a good idea of my opinion on them before you do it, et cetera, et cetera. There's just so much that that I think the hobby in general is going to benefit from being out here and me documenting it in an online video type format. The website should be up within about 60 days as well. I'm holding off on that until I actually have something to put on it. You know, launching a website of an empty room doesn't sound as exciting as waiting until things are out here. So that website is coming. If you have any suggestions for things you'd like to see on there, let me know. I'm going to break down costs, you know, give you guys a total and tally where all the money's gone and how it was all spent. Do step-by-step informational things as to how all of this was built. But also something that's exciting to me and something that I really want to do is each tank is going to be broken down so that you can get detailed information on each aquarium, the water parameters, the stocking, you know, feeding regime, the, you know, what type of food, every detail and aspect of it, all of the equipment running, and I hope to be able to provide you with links to be able to find out where I got everything and so forth. Just basically a tell-all of each individual tank, because I do find that sometimes in videos it's difficult to capture everything I want to talk about, or you forget something, etc. And some of you are also asking me, when do the 3 videos a week or 5 videos a week start? Simple answer is, whenever I have enough content to make 3 or 5 videos a week. Right now, there's a lot of work going in out here, but I think within about the 60 to 90 day mark, we're going to jump up to those 3 videos a week, potentially more. Until then, guys, I think that's about everything I kind of wanted to talk about out here. Anyways, thanks for watching. I'll see you guys Thursday?